Okay, so like, this is the fourth time you've been late, and honestly, it's starting to be a little stereotypical.
Y'all don't have to drive in traffic, okay?
How much traffic?
Right, like, how far away from the school do you live?
You must be coming from up north. Like, do you get on I-85 South or just get on 285 West?
When I lived in Alpharetta, it took me just 45 minutes to get here.
Right, you don't know how to speed? It may say 55 miles per hour, but my mama is always going at least like 80, 90.
Don't incriminate your mama right now.
You must be in a hoopty, like, because, you know, the engine's on hoopties, and, you know, it takes a while for the engine to
turn over. Oh, okay, okay. Our lives are governed by physical quantities. These are amounts that can be measured. How far do we live? How much time do we have left? How fast are we moving? How much gas do we have left? How much money do we have to buy gas? All physical quantities fall into two categories: scalars and vectors. Scalars are quantities that measure magnitude only. Magnitude is just a fancy word for amount. Whereas vectors measure magnitude and direction. Example, this 145-gram baseball flew in the air for 10 seconds. Mass and time are scalar quantities. They just measure the size or amount. Whereas the baseball flew because it was hit by a force of 100 newtons east, and it accelerated east. Force and acceleration are vectors. They measure size and they note the direction it was going.
None of that explains why you were late today.
Well, I live 50 kilometers away from the school.
Okay, so do I.
Well, I live 50 kilometers north of the school.
Oh, I live 50 kilometers south of the school. Yeah, okay.
Right. The distance we live away from the school is the same. Distance is simply how far away an object is or has traveled.
Oh, and it doesn't account for direction.
Exactly. Okay. Our displacement is different. Displacement is the change in position of an object, how far away it is from its starting point in a certain frame of reference. So, here's the school. I live 50 kilometers north of the school.
Oh, you live up near
when
the
I arrive to school, what is the distance that I've traveled?
50 kilometers.
Yep.
Right. Mm-hmm. What is my displacement relative to my house?
Of 50 kilometers south of the school? 50 kilometers south.
Yes. So when it's time for me to go back home, let's say I get halfway home. What's the total distance I've traveled this entire route so far?
50 plus 25, 75 kilometers.
Yes. However, what's my displacement? Or how far am I from my house where I started?
Ooh, 25 kilometers south. 25 kilometers south.
Yes. So when I reach my house, what's the total distance I've traveled since I left home in the morning?
Add them all together.
100 kilometers.
Yes. What's my displacement, though?
Zero. Zero? You're not displaced.
Right. Because I'm back where I started.
Okay.
And we can represent these displacement values as vectors.
I know. You already told us that.
Well, no. This time, I mean vectors. A noun, not an adjective.
Oh my gosh.
This is not ELA. I did not come in here for all of this.
We can represent any vector quantity as an arrow. The length of the arrow represents its magnitude, and the direction of the arrow represents the direction. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so.
You can add vectors together if they are parallel or on the same axis. However, let me show you the actual route I take, because I don't really live 50 kilometers north of the school. I live a little bit over here.
I was lying.
You see, right?
Yes.
Okay, it makes sense though.
But what's the total distance that I actually travel?
75 kilometers
right.
Then.
Why don't you just take the interstate, right?
Like, won't it save you some distance, I think?
How could we figure that out? Because you just
Well, since these two vectors are not parallel, we actually have to use a different trick. Something I'm sure you learned in your geometry class. It's called the Pythagorean Theorem.
This is physics.
Oh, Ms. Lucas taught us that.
Yes.
Oh, she did. I love her.
When we're dealing with a right triangle, we can use a squared plus b squared equals c squared.
Right.
Does it matter which side is a or b?
No.
No.
Just
as long as you don't pick the hypotenuse.
Okay.
All right.
So, square that. Square that.
Yes. Okay.
Awesome. We don't care about c squared. We want c by itself. So we have to do the opposite of squaring a number, which is...
dividing by two?
No. The opposite of squaring a number is the square root. So let's take the square root.
55?
Yes. 55.09 kilometers. So if we need to figure out how much distance it would save me, we take my original route, 75 kilometers, subtract 55.09.
Mm-hmm. About 20.
So if I took the interstate, it would save me 19.91 kilometers.
So take that route then. Like, what do you mean?
Well, there's one problem. It may save me some distance, but the time that it takes me to get here using the interstate is actually much longer. And if that's the case, I'm moving slower on that route.
True.
The rate at which an object travels a distance in a set amount of time is known as speed. The rate at which an object is displaced in an amount of time is known as velocity.
So velocity is really just speed?
Yes, but with a direction added.
Okay, but none of this explains why you're always late still.
Well, how long does it take for you to get to school, Matt?
About 30 minutes. I think so, yeah.
Okay. So, 50 kilometers north in half of an hour. We'll take that displacement, 50 kilometers north, and divide it by the time it takes you to arrive. Half an hour, or 0.5 hours.
Okay, 30 minutes.
So your velocity is 100 kilometers per hour north. If we were to let you go at that rate for an hour, you would be 100 kilometers north of where you started. Whereas when I'm on the interstate going 50 kilometers south, it takes me 1 hour and a half to get here.
What?
I can't see that happening.
So, I don't believe it.
50 kilometers south divided by 1.5 hours is 33.33 kilometers per hour south.
You just need to get up earlier.
My velocity is much lower than yours traveling south through the city on the interstate.
I think you're lying, but why do we have speed limits but no velocity limits?
Think about what you're saying here. If we said you were limited to driving 100 kilometers per hour north, which is a velocity, what would that mean for all people driving in other directions?
I can drive however fast I want if I'm going south, right?
Right.
Yeah.
People are driving in all directions when they're on the road. So, it would be best to use a scalar quantity, like speed, since that only limits how fast you're going, but it doesn't limit your direction. Therefore, it would apply to everyone. Now, of course you know that I was not going 33 kilometers per hour south the entire route. That's better known as my average velocity. If we were to analyze how fast I was going, let's say right at 7:46 a.m., that would be my instantaneous velocity.
You should have left earlier.
The odometer on a vehicle is showing you the instantaneous velocity, how fast the vehicle is going in that moment, but it doesn't show you how fast you were going over the entire journey.
Okay.
True. Well, on the surface street, like, you have to start and stop over and over again at the red light. So wouldn't that slow you down over the whole journey? I mean,
yes, but my engine is a 6-cylinder. So my car has the ability to accelerate very quickly.
Well, you still have to follow the speed limit, though.
Yes, but acceleration is not about how fast or how high your velocity is. It's about how quickly you can change your velocity. Acceleration is the rate of change in velocity. So cars with a 4-cylinder engine have a lower acceleration than a six-cylinder engine.
So that means they can't go as fast as a six-cylinder, right?
No, it just takes them a longer time to change their velocity.
Oh, it takes them a longer amount of time to speed
up? Exactly.
Gotcha.
But acceleration doesn't only apply to speeding up, but also slowing down and changing direction.
Wait, changing direction?
Mm. Okay,
why?
Well, if a car goes from 100 kilometers per hour south to 100 kilometers per hour north, are those the same velocity?
Oh, no.
Okay.
No.
So if the velocity changes in any way, that is acceleration. Even let's say if a Ferris wheel is going at a constant speed.
It's still accelerating because it's changing direction.
Oh, in a circle.
Right.
Okay.
And acceleration can be calculated.
Of course.
If we needed to talk about a change in your grade in this class, we would need to know your grade in the beginning and your grade at the end.
Whose grade is that? Oh my God.
That'd not be mine.
Mm-mm.
Yes, if we needed to know about a change in velocity, we would need to know its velocity at the beginning and its velocity at the end. Not only that, we need to know the time that it took for that velocity to change. So, if my car goes from rest to 4 meters per second within 3 seconds, what's the car's acceleration? What is its initial velocity?
It's what?
Initial velocity. Just like your initials are the letters at the beginning of your name, initial velocity is the velocity at the beginning. So again, what is its initial velocity?
I don't see a number for whatever it
starts. It starts from rest.
See how fast we're going.
Starts from rest, so it's zero.
Okay. What velocity did it end with?
4 meters per second.
And how long did it take the car to do that?
3 seconds. Right? Yeah.
So let's do the math. 4 minus 0 is
4.
Duh.
And then 4 divided by 3.
1.33. Repeat.
All right.
So
this means that the car's velocity is increasing by 1.33 meters per second every second.
Speeding up.
Oh, okay.
We write the unit for acceleration as meters per second per second. Or better yet, meters per second squared.
Oh, yeah.
A car in front of me slams on their brakes, and I go from 4 meters per second to rest, but only within 2 seconds. What's my acceleration?
Well, this time you started at 4 meters per second and ended at 0 within 2 seconds.
0 minus 4 is -4. So -4 divided by 2. That'll give you
The acceleration is negative?
Negative acceleration tends to denote slowing down. So, -2 meters per second squared.
Okay. So your velocity decreased by 2 meters per second every second. Makes sense. Can we speed up this lesson, please?
How about we speed up our work on some practice problems then?
How about you slow down?
How about you change direction and get back on the interstate?
How about I increase the amount of time you spend in high school when you don't pass my final exam?
Let's talk about your displacement from your job when I tell the principal about how late you are to school each day.
Let's talk about the velocity that your mama was driving in the parking lot.
Let's talk about
when she came.
How every day you always coming in here and got an attitude.
I'm calling right now.
Trying to drone on somebody. Like,